2013 here tonight. If you want to keep track of the live scoring, you can do so at LucasDirt.com, LucasDirt.com. Heat number two will follow. So Chris Madden, the team zero by Bloomquist, 44. Fourth of the top was wanted last week at Batesville, Arkansas, former rookie of the year, the Clint Boyer Peak Oil 5. It'll be Jared Landers. Oh, baby, two hard chargers on the front row. Here we go. Oh, they're all out of shape. And problems off the start. And it'll be a redo. And Earl Pearson Jr. Wow. Right in the Scorcher. Presented by Reese Monument Cup. And I get a Tazewell, Tennessee. Here we go. Out of turn four. They dive into one. Madden Landers on the gas. Wolfenbarger sideways. Jacobson O'Neill up through there. O'Neill started last. Blankenship up to third as Pearson went to the pits as they came out of four, charging down the main straightaway. Jacobson O'Neill, they got into it last week at Batesville. And they're running hard side by side down the back straightaway here in this heat tonight. Wolfenbarger back into fourth. Madden will lead. Landers, Blankenship up at turn four. Down the back straightaway. Again, the winner's third to the pole here tonight. Chris Madden, the winner at Cherokee, his home track back in June. Down the back straightaway. Into turn three, Landers runs second. Blankenship is third. Wolfenbarger fourth. O'Neill fifth. Jacobson runs in sixth. Down the main straightaway. Here in Wild Soil, late on the dirt series before a jam pack. Volunteer Speedway, halfway, five down, five to go. Down the main straightaway, four to go, the top three remain the same. Wolfenbarger trying to get that fourth slot over O'Neill, who's running last. O'Neill, ignition problems, hot lapping. And a flat tire at his qualification run. Several wins here in the past. And Boyer in the house tonight watching one of his two cars in this race. Landers trying to track him down. White flag, one to go. Out of turn two, Blankenship remains in third. O'Neill is into fourth. Final time around at Volunteer Speedway. He wanted it. Smoky Madden with a win. Landers second, third Blankenship. O'Neill recovers to gain the fourth spot in car 71. And your winner, he drives the Hamricks of Gaffney, Henderson Amusement, Clements Power, Team Zero by Bloomquist, the 44 out of Gaffney, South Carolina. How about a big round of applause for Chris Smokey Madden, your winner? Kill Engines for several years, been in the Roush Yates now for a while. The veteran engine builder and driver of the outside furrow, Steve Francis, the Clint Boyer, Georgia Boot 15, Dennis Erb Jr., the Heather Lyon crew chief, 28 team zero by Bloomquist entry. Sixth of the Lucas Oil points for the blue and black, 28. Here we go. 10 laps, the top four to the Scorcher at Bulls Gap. Big Hill out of turn two is going to grab the lead over Bloomquist. Francis third, Erb runs fourth. Here they come out of turn four. They're side by side for the lead, a car length. It's Big Hill at the gap. Time track champion out of turn two down the back straightaway. Vic the Thrill Hill in that Warrior trying to hold off the Bloomquist. It's a dandy. They're still side by side up a four at the line. Zero by a nose. Bloomquist by a nose. Now Vic Hill will try the crossover down the back straightaway. He'll go to the left rear quarter panel of Bloomquist now. As he backs out of the gas, Bloomquist out in front at Bulls Gap. Scott Bloomquist has one Lucas Oil victory, the all-time winningest driver, 46 career wins, but only one here in 2013. That came at East Bay back in February. Francis runs third, Erb is fourth. Francis second Lucas Oil points, Erb is sixth. As they come out of turn two, Case Bolt runs fifth, and it's Ogle Jr., Chad Ogle, and then Bobby Giffen. Bloomquist pulling away down the front straightaway. Well, Hawkeye Trucking's Quick Manufacturing number zero. Down the back straightaway for the Hall of Famer, over 500 career victories. As he heads into turn four. Four to go here at the gap. Hill second, Francis trying to catch him. And John Blankenship, he's already in the show. Owens is coming up next. Blankenship third in points, O'Neill fourth. They made it out of the first heat. Francis trying to get it going, a former Scorcher winner here. Francis into one. The Clint Boyer 15 with the boss of the house out of two. Down the back straightaway, Irba solid fourth. As they come down the main straightaway, give them two to go for Scott Bloomquist. And the Roush heats forward. Bloomquist race cars entry down the back straightaway. Francis and Herb trying to get around the veteran Vic Hill. As they come out of four, white flag to Bloomquist. One to go for the boss of Team Zero. As he's quickly out of turn two as the car is running behind him and quickly now in the turn two. And Scott Bloomquist pulls away to start on the inside of row number two tonight at the Scorcher. Vic Hill's going to finish second, Francis third, Herb is fourth. And your winner, the Sweet Manufacturing, Hawkeye Trucking, Roush Yates, Bloomquist for the zero out of Mooresburg, Tennessee. Put your hands together for your winner, Scott Bloomquist. So two heats in the books, both won by Bloomquist cars, Madden and the boss himself. Billy Ogle Jr., that Rocket Vic Hill power plant under the hood, Massey Electric, Cherokee Millwright. The Geo Services entry. Crew chiefing David Bryant tonight, both Billy Ogle Jr. and Trevor Bain, who's in the next heat, coming up next. Bain, a good qualifying lap, will start inside row two of heat four, which is next. But heat three, the top four to the Scorcher, presented by Reese Monument Company. Here we go. Maybe. Yes. Ogle Jr. Oh, it's a nice slider into two around Carrier. And it'll be a redo, though. Did I like the start of that race? It'll be a redo. As they're going to bring it back. So Ogle Jr., the 48-year-old veteran who just turned 49 back this week on the 17th of August. 49-year-old veteran, multi-time track champion at Atomic Speedway. Here we go. And this time, Carrier's going to grab the advantage. He'll go right with him as Owens and Asbury get together. Meanwhile, side by side for the lead. It's going to be a battle of the line. And by a nose, it's Ogle Jr. Oh, baby. Eddie Carrier Jr. second down the back straightaway. Third is Owens. Fourth is Asbury. As they come out of turn number four, good battle for the lead at the gap. Billy Ogle Jr., Eddie Carrier Jr., Jimmy Owens. Out of turn two, Ogle nearly turned it sideways down the back straightaway for the second generation driver. Out of Knoxville, Tennessee, down the straightaway. Billy Ogle Jr. with the lead. Now Owens works on Carrier. Well, Owens is going to have a try for a better starting spot because Francis is in, Blankenship is in, O'Neill is in. He is not in yet. He's got to get in the top four of this one right now, running in the third spot, trying to get around fellow Lucas Oil regular Eddie Carrier Jr. Now Owens goes to the top shelf with car owner Mike Reese looking on. Here he comes into turn four, ECJ in a one. Will lead the O-Show as they come out of two. Good battle, five down, five to go. Ogle Jr. pulling away. Michael Asbury runs fourth. It is GRT out of Crossville. Meanwhile, all eyes on that second place run right here. Good battle. Owens, 20. Carrier, 28. Down the back straightaway. The two veterans going at it. In a three. Carrier trying to hold off Owens as they come out of turn four. Owens has a run. Carrier holds him off. Three to go. And a good battle right here continues. Owens stays married to the bottom. Carrier up top the middle group. He'll dive into three. ECJ will close the door on Owens. In a turn four. Two to go. Ogle Jr. to the front row. It looks like tonight. Madden, Ogle. Look to be your front row tonight. Carrier second in this race. Owens third. Fourth is Asbury. Owens trying hard again. Carrier up on the wheel into one. Owens now one final run down the back straightaway. He tries to pull even. Meanwhile, Ogle Jr., see you later. He's going to win. Carrier drifts up the track. Here comes Owens down the straightaway at the line. It's going to be Carrier second. Owens third. Fourth is Asbury. Good race for second. Carrier Jr. And your winner, the Massey Electric Cherokee Millwright VP Blunt Excavating Geo Services Vic Hill Rocket in the 201. He's going to try to defend that Scorcher from the outside of the front row at Knoxville, Tennessee. How about it, fans, for Billy Ogle Jr.? Quality photography, Roush Yates Engines, Roush Yates Parts, Simpson Performance Products, Sweet Manufacturing, Traeger Grills, Weld Racing, Wiles Drive Shafts, and 5150 Race Trailers. Fourth and finally, the winner's going to start at the outside of row two tonight. Here we go. Neil McDowell, two straight third place finishes. And the Snow Cone North South winner in the Comp Cams Topless 100. Not a good start for Weaver. How about Trevor Bain in a second? Trevor Bain in his first one of the year on dirt and a dirt lane model. Rocket chassis. David Bryant, crew chief, as he comes out of turn two. Trevor Bain in second. In the top four to the Scorcher. And we got a big spin in turn four, and Hendricks is slow, and the caution is out. Sure. How about Trevor Bain running in second? A good qualifying time in that sixth car.
He's adapted to dirt real well.
For the Wood Brothers as well for next year. So he comes into this weekend. He'll be running Bristol tomorrow night, eighth in the nationwide points, Doug. All right, two down, eight to go. McDowell, your leader, off of turn four. Trevor Bain, can he keep that car? There he goes. He straightens it out down the back straightaway. Weaver will try the inside. Crabtree trying to make his first Lucas Oil race of the season. Bain looks like he makes up the second spot. He yanks top. Almost got in the wall. Keeps it off the concrete. He's hanging in there in third. Can he make the show? He didn't make it last year. Right now in third. As Trevor Bain, very few laps in this car tonight. Meanwhile, Crabtree on the bottom. They go side by side. Halfway next time. Bain hanging on. Trevor Bain. Crabtree on the bottom. We got a spin, and it's the 23. And there, caution is out. Caution is out. His teammate, Billy Ogle Jr., is going to be on the front row tonight with Chris Madden. So it's McDowell, Weaver, Bain, Crabtree, Brunson, and Hendricks. Here we go. Four down, six to go. Dale McDowell, he's going to be a solid contender for the victory tonight. Can he finally break through in the victory? It's been a few years at the Lucas Oil A-Mod Dirt Series. McDowell down the main straightaway in that Team Dillon Warrior. Out of turn number two, Randy Weaver second. Trevor Bain runs third. David Crabtree fourth. Hendricks fifth. Sixth runs Brunson. Down the main straightaway. It is all Dale Mack. Dale Mack pulling away, second spot, Randy Weaver, Trevor Bain, solid third. Trevor Bain dives to the bottom. Made a stab at the 116. Bain getting used to that number six car. Rocket chassis, Ford power under the hood down the back straightaway. As he's starting to close, Randy Weaver. Here comes Bain bouncing through three and four. The white flag is out. McDowell down the back straightaway. Could tonight be the night for Dale Mack to become the 16th different winner this year in the Lucas Oil A-Mod Series. He gets it at an FK Rod and seat four-year winner. Second spot will be Randy Weaver. Trevor Bain will go to third. And David Crabtree finishes in fourth. And you're one of the Children's Institute for Pediatric Trauma Clot Synthetic Lubricants. Earnhardt Childress Engine for the Warrior of Team Dillon. The 41 out of Chickamauga, Georgia, ladies and gentlemen. How about it for Mac Daddy Dale McDowell?
We make dirt race fans out of them. A year, that's about all they run in any racetrack. But without those folks, we don't know what we'd do when it comes to Bristol Race Week without the Lucas Oil Dirt Late Model Series coming to town. Blank of McMahon, Jarnigan, Mays, Witt. What's the brakes on the number 9? Left rear of the car. A lot of smoke coming out of the 25 as he gets up in the wall in turn 2. McMahon out front. Blanken, Mays. Witt comes in, takes over 4th. The 25 car really, really slow up high. That's Landon Williams. So Landon Williams in the pit. So, 10-lap segment of Hobby Havoc.
On the track here, he was here several years ago with his Hall of Fame dad, Billy Moyer. We got some scratches out there. As you mentioned, it looks like Earl Pearson's going to take a provisional. He would be the first in Lucas Oil provisional land. Moyer Jr. will be the second one if he didn't make it out of this one. So, here we go. And green flag, Wolfenbarger, Case Bolt, local. Jacobson and Moyer Jr. out of turn 2, and Case Bolt has the lead. Of course, that car based here at East Tennessee, Danny Dishman, Ronald Ivy, the DNR Racing Masters built Case Bolt with the lead. Into turn number 1, out of 2. That's what they do. They keep it down there in East Tennessee. Case Bolt from Indiana. Ogle runs in second. Wolfenbarger comes Jacobson on the outside. EJ trying to get to the show. Wolfenbarger had a good qualifying time tonight. Jacobson, Moyer Jr. now. Moyer Jr. getting some valuable laps. If he doesn't make it, he would be the second Lucas Oil provisional. Now Jacobson on the bottom, digging hard. Off at turn 4. Good battle here in this first of 2 B-Mains of Lucas Oil late model dead series. Ogle, Wolfenbarger, Jacobson trying to get in the top 3 to make the show. As they come out of turn 4, Jacobson gets a turn sideways, gets his train back out. Case Bolt cruising on now down the back straightaway for the C9. Masters built for the veteran, the 35-year-old veteran of Indiana. Meanwhile, Jacobson on the bottom. Jacobson in that black 5 making it work hard. He and Wolfenbarger and Jacobson, solid, strong move to 3rd. Jacobson will take 3rd. Now Wolfenbarger, and going to get into him as they hit it at turn number 4. Wolfenbarger got right into Jacobson.
I don't know whether you call that aggressive or just pure race. Goes around. Halfway in, though. 6 to go, so anything
that's
can happen.
That's why. Whether you think it's fair or not, that's the no judgment call. So
Three cars advance. Moyer Jr. goes to the back. Jacobson up high. Works on Wolfenbarger. There's a little bad blood there, so we'll see what happens.
Well, Jacobson's still got 5 laps here to get back up there, and I wouldn't doubt if he does it because he's driving the California down to turn 2. You being from California, you better be able to drive in traffic, hadn't you?
But Wolfenbarger's working on 2nd.
Yeah, Wolfenbarger working on 2nd on Ogle. Jacobson charging hard. Wolfenbarger up the track. Jacobson on the gas down the back straightaway. Wolfenbarger now, and he gets into Ogle. Here comes Jacobson on the bottom.
What a battle for 2nd.
Wolfenbarger bending some sheet metal tonight, isn't he? It's like, I'm going to do Jacobson on
what
the
run.
Right away, the crowd goes nuts.
What a
and
run.
He'll elbow him. He'll elbow him. He'll throw him up the, oh, my. He knocked him to Bristol. He knocked him to Bristol. 2 to go.
I think that was sweet revenge. About right back at him.
Wolfenbarger, they don't touch wheels. White flag, final lap, keep an eye on him. 28-5 for the final spot to the feature tonight. Jacobson trying to get away from him. They go into 3. Wolfenbarger, final turn, lap. Case Bolt wins, Ogle 2nd, Jacobson 3rd.
Raced his way in from starting last. That little bad blood, watch him down the backstretch here as Wolfenbarger and Jacobson battled hard.
Jacobs is probably laughing under that helmet. The top 3 go to the big show. They got across the scales 1st. And your winner, the Hicks and Eagle Company General Contractors, B&M Concrete, Harrison Concrete Masters built the C9 out of Richmond, Indiana. Ladies and gentlemen, how about it for your winner, Steve Casebolt?
You know, I knew he'd get up there and try to go.
The 23B trying to get in the show tonight.
I like the old school part.
He's only been here once before. Let's see if Brunson Connecticut end and the youngster Josh Henry at 25 and Andrew Gordon out of Pennsylvania in the 18. 12 laps, the top three to the Scorcher here tonight at the Gap.
Half of them's going home out of this heat.
Out of turn. Oh, look, three wide, Doug. Look out down the back straightaway. Brunson on the outside. Douglas, Brunson. Oh, baby, looking like a pinball did Brunson, and Brunson's going to go to third. How about that?
That was some race right there, and it ain't over yet.
You got to root for Jay Brunson. He's traveled all over the Lucas Oil Series from Louisiana on an open trailer, trying to get to the show here tonight. It's 800 to start. He's not worried about that. He just wants to get in the show as he goes down the back straightaway. Douglas is second, but out in front, it's Brian Hendricks looking good.
Hendricks has been here many times. Of course, he's a several-time track champion over at Tazewell. Mark Douglas right behind him, several-time track champion here at Volunteer Speedway. As Josh Henry slows in turn two, brings the Peg Leg Motorsports in.
Well, to Brad, the leader spins out of two. Your leader spins. He rolled the left rear tire off. Brian Hendricks rolled the left rear off that Masters build. He spun, it looks like, out of turn two, he did. And he doesn't even have a tire rack on it. He has to haul the tires in the back of his pickup truck.
Lead after Hendricks, bad luck. And their crew looks like they're working maybe on the five car of Hendricks, but if not,
he does get courtesy laps in the Lucas Oil Series if he's able to continue.
Three out of four cars will advance as they come into green, James. Four laps in the books.
Here we go. Green is out. Now we got a battle here. Four left for three spots. Down the back straightaway, Ramey's got third right now. The Ironton, Ohio veteran. Out of turn two, here comes young Andrew Gordon down the front straightaway. Andrew Gordon, his first time here out of Pennsylvania. Out of turn number two, trying to get in the show against the Buckeye State. So the Pennsylvania Buckeye border war going out of here for the third and final transfer spot. As it's all Mark Douglas right now.
Maryville, Tennessee driver. Knows how to get around the gap. Pulls out pretty good. And I'll tell you what, the 23 car, with a little luck, I think he's going to make the show tonight. But there ain't no luck about it. If you can get around these high banks as he speeds, you are a professional.
On the back straightaway, Mark Douglas, the 42-year-old veteran of Knoxville, Tennessee, the Rocket Chevrolet. Vic Hill power plant under the hood. Brunson hanging on for second. Ramey third. Gordon is fourth. As the laps wind down, four to go. Down the back straightaway. Boy, what a tough break for Brian Hendricks. He had a good lead. Rolled the left rear tire off coming out of turn two and spun. Meanwhile, Gordon back in the hunt. Andrew Gordon, his first time here. Can he make the show out of turn number two? Gordon on the gas down the back straightaway now. He'll set up Ramey now. Out of turn four. As the laps wind down, it's all Mark Douglas. But right now, all eyes on that third spot. Can Gordon get a run? Down the back straightaway, Gordon. He gets low down there. As they come out of four, white flag is out, one to go. Brunson second, Ramey third. Fourth is Gordon, final lap. Down the back straightaway, two-time Volunteer Speedway track champion Mark Douglas is going to go to the big show tonight, the Scorcher at the Gap. Jay Brunson's going to finish second at 23. Third is Ramey, fourth is Gordon. And your winner, the FSR Performance Parts, Laney & Sons Construction, Allied Glass Company, Worldwide Equipment, Vic Hill, Rocket, the 52D out of Knoxville, Tennessee. How about it for two-time track champion Mark Douglas?
Give it up for Douglas, folks. 52D in the show for you for 15 laps. 50-50 ticket. Mac Mahan, Blanket. And look at the leader is off the pace. Warm back my hand off the pace. Blanken goes to the point. As Warren McMahon in the 33 car drops down low, Jamie Whitt up the second, Mike Mays, Jarnigan, and we got a caution on lap one. Into his pit area. Looks like he's probably done for the night. His ticket number is worth $822. 057620 057620. On the backstretch, Mays, Jarnigan, your top three. Jamie Woods up in the floor. Mays and real hard. Caution on lap number 11. Jamie Whitt loops it over in 3 and 4. Robbie Woods in that 2 car all the way up in the second. Jardigan third, Mays in the fourth. Bumper to bumper down the back straightaway. Let's see if anybody can get a break coming out of wall 4. Battle for second. Woods is there. Jarnigan looking. And we got all over the racetrack. All over the racetrack. Austin Atkins goes up in smoke. Leaves a trail of moisture, not sure what it is at this time, on lap 12. Track officials going out to see what kind of liquid we have. Get the car here. The veteran out of Moorestown, Tennessee, Gary Blanken, modified hobby. Congratulations, Gary. He said, see that checkered flag, that's all you needed to see, right?
That's right. Well, I'll tell you, it's a good night. Come up here. I've only run this car twice this year, an old motor. It'll run when you get going, but it won't take off for nothing. God dang, it won't. It takes the whole straightaway to get took off. I'm going to have to do something to it.
Might need more gear.
That's part of it. I changed the gear, and I went way too high.
Driver era?
Yeah, mechanic era.
Who we need to thank?
Well, I want to thank my girlfriend. She supports me in this all the time. And Trevor come and helped me some. Scotty, he showed up and helped me here at the track. Me and her come by ourselves, and I forget who I was down there helping. But this car here, like I say, I ain't running it none. I drive another car at Tazewell all the time. And this in here, it's just second time we've got it out this year.
Well, it worked out good for us. Let's give it a great big hand. More Gary Blanken.
Who will it be tonight? Billy Yogel Jr. won a thrilling battle here last year with Scott Blomquist. It came down to
Blomquist,
the last lap.
McDowell, Landers, Carrier. Who is it going to be tonight? Dale McDowell, two consecutive third-place finishes. Florence, Kentucky, 2 weeks ago, beats Arkansas last Sunday in the Comp Camps, topless 100. We're getting ready for showtime. The Lucas Oil Late Model Dirt Series in the Scorcher 50 at Volunteer Speedway is going green. Turn number four down the main straightaway. Chris Madden will lead lap one. As Herb is out of shape, Blomquist jumps to second. Ogle third, fourth McDowell, fifth is Landers. One in the books here tonight. 50 laps, 10,000 to win the 28th Lucas Oil race of the season. 15 different winners already this season. Madden, as I mentioned, what a Cherokee. Back in the month of June. McDowell will try the inside of Ogle Jr. He'll throw the right elbow. They're rubbing. Rubbing is racing, and McDowell will get the spot. McDowell will jump into third. Ogle Jr. back to Ford Landers, fifth, sixth Carrier. Seventh is Hill, eighth is Owens. Off at turn four, it's still Chris Madden with the lead. Scott Blomquist second, Dale McDowell third, Billy Moyer Jr., Billy Ogle Jr., other runs it fourth. Landers fifth, now Hill at the bottom. Hill around Carrier. Vic Hill, five-time Volunteer track champion now. Makes his presence known as Ogle Jr. Battles with McDowell at a turn two, five complete. And McDowell, the 41, the 201 of Ogle Jr. going at it down the main straightaway. Battle there. Fifth is Landers, sixth is Hill, seventh Carrier, eighth is Owens, ninth is Weaver, tenth is Blankenship. Remember, Blankenship comes in ninth, third in the points. Francis right behind him as they come up at turn four. Blankenship 10th, Francis 11th.
trying to close on Owens with seven in the books and tighten up that battle as we head to Lawrenceburg, Indiana, Saturday night. Meanwhile, Chad Ogle slows at turn two, and that's going to bring out a caution as they go down the back straightaway. As the caution is out for Chad Ogle. Chad Ogle brings out a caution. He slows out at turn two. Fast time. One is heat trying for the sweeper tonight. In that Clements Power Team, zero by Bloomquist, 44. McDowell on the inside of Bloomquist, Landers and Ogle Jr. off at turn four, back underway at Volunteer Speedway. Down the back straightaway, Ogle Jr. and McDowell got together. Ogle Jr. is going to slide that 201 in there higher. McDowell holds the spot, Madden over Bloomquist into one. Scott Bloomquist has not won a Lucas Oil race since February at East Bay, the all-time winningest driver of the series. 46 career wins. Vic Hill on the bottom. Vic Hill, five-time track champion, moves to fifth at car number one. Douglas is out in 52. 10 in the books. Madden, Bloomquist, McDowell third, fourth Ogle Jr., and a battle back and forth. Now Landers had the spot. Oh, and Owens up to sixth. Hill to fifth. Sixth is Owens, and look down, Owens may have trouble. Owens may have trouble, he's got a flat tire. Jimmy Owens has a flat tire, got him between, he's going to get rid of O'Neill, and O'Neill flips on his lead at turn two, and the red will be out. Red flag is out as Owens slowed with a flat tire, and O'Neill then nowhere to go and ends up on his top, and the red is out. All right, word from the track, all drivers are okay. All drivers are okay. So we'll check out O'Neill as he did the flip in turn number two, the rollover. Will they win it? He'll have to battle his way back up in there. So a golden opportunity for Steve Francis and John Blankenship to cut into the points lead tonight by Jimmy Owens as they get by the turn number four, but all eyes up front for that 10 grand of the winner. Who's it going to be tonight? Good restart for Madden. McDowell on the bottom. Dale McDowell said, oh, Bloomquist has a problem at turn number two. And a slip back to fourth. Bloomquist from second to fourth. Out of turn four, it's Madden, McDowell, Ogle Jr., and then Bloomquist. Big Hill running in fifth. Here comes Blankenship. Blankenship will go to sixth around Carrier. And look out on the back straightaway, Asbury, Trevor Bain involved, and the caution is out. As Asbury and Bain got together in the back straightaway, and the driver that's currently eighth in the nationwide points. How about Dale McDowell as Bloomquist on the restart lost a couple of spots. He's back to fourth. All right, 12 in the books, 38 to go. We'll double them up behind your leader because Smoky Mountain is going to come out of turn number four. Dale McDowell looking for his sixth career Lucas Oil victory. And that's three, Ogle Jr. Vic Hill on the bottom. Vic Hill with a move again. Hill gains another spot. The five-time track champion. Here comes John Blankenship on the prowl. Blankenship, here he comes, digging hard. As they come out of turn two, Bloomquist back around Hill. Hill about to back on the inside. They dive at a three, off of four. Madden will lead, 14 scored at the gap. It's Madden, McDowell, Ogle Jr., Bloomquist, Hill fifth, sixth Blankenship, seventh Carrier, eighth Weaver, ninth Francis. Jimmy Owens back to 10th. Owens has come from the back to 10th in the turn one is your leader. Lap 16, Chris Madden has led every lap here tonight at a turn. Number four, Dale McDowell, second. Billy Ogle Jr., last year's winner here, runs fourth. Bloomquist all over him in the fourth spot. Hill remains sixth. Blankenship seventh. Carrier eighth. Battle between the top two and the points. 15, Steve Francis. 20, Jimmy Owens. It was 25 points before last weekend. Right now, Owens leading by 75. And Francis trying to cut into that some more before we head to Indiana Saturday night. Meanwhile, Madden is on cruise control right now to turn two. has a good lead down the back straightaway. Dale McDowell, Billy Ogle Jr., Scott Bloomquist, a good battle for second. Fifth remains Vic Hill. Sixth, John Blankenship. Seventh, Eddie Carey Jr. Eighth, Steve Francis. Ninth, Jimmy Owens. Tenth, Randy Weaver. Owens trying at bottom, down the main straightaway. Meanwhile, Madden, Chris Madden, already to turn number one. Yet to have any traffic with a number of cautions and, of course, that red flag early on as Chris Madden battles out of turn number four down the front straightaway. And now to turn two, will move in on Louisiana's Jay Brunson, the last car on the lead lap. Dale McDowell, Billy Ogle, Scott Bloomquist, the two drivers that ran a heck of a race here a year ago. Meanwhile, Blankenship will try to bottom a hill out of turn four. They're side by side. Blankenship on the bottom hill as the event. Up top, they might have touched on the main straightaway. Wow, 1-23 Hill and Blankenship. Contact on the main straightaway. Now Madden's got to be careful with Brunson out of turn two down the back straightaway. 23 complete. Ogle Jr. now starting to close the run here. And then McDowell now as Ogle Jr. makes the run. McDowell may have a problem as they come out of turn four. Ogle Jr. going to second. Yep. McDowell still has full power, it looks like, but he lost the spot as Bloomquist now will challenge him off of four. Halfway. Madden's already down the back straightaway to turn three. The second place on back's coming out of two. Chris Madden right now. 26 complete as we have a long green flag run here as Madden down the back straightaway behind Billy Moyer Jr. and Trevor Bain. Tell you, Billy, oh, we got a car in turn four. Looks like Randy Weaver slows. Caution is out. Randy Weaver slows in turn four. Madden in traffic. Can the defending Scorcher winner pull out another one here tonight at Volunteer Speedway? 23 to go at the gap. Here they come. Owens battling back. Jimmy Owens battling from the back. He's gotten around Francis. He eyes Blankenship. Off at turn four, Madden will lead Ogle to the line. McDowell third, Bloomquist fourth, fifth is Hill, sixth Carrier, seventh Blankenship, eighth is Owens, ninth is Francis, tenth is Dennis Erb. And I complete 20 to go coming up. Owens trying at bottom out of Blankenship down the back straightaway. Francis and Erb. Francis second on the points. Erb is sixth. Madden continues to lead. Ogle Jr. now picking up the pace down the back straightaway. Here comes Billy Ogle Jr. We got a battle up front, folks. Business is picking up here for the lead into one. McDowell Bloomquist, good battle for third. Bloomer on the bottom out of two down the back straightaway. Fifth is Hill, sixth Carrier, seventh Blankenship, eighth Owens, ninth Francis, tenth is Erb. Meanwhile, the top two right here. Looks like it's going to go down to 44-201 with 18 to go out of two. Dale McDowell, the team Dillon 41, right now in third. It would be his third consecutive third-place finish. How about that? They come out of turn four. Billy Ogle Jr., can he go for the win 2 years in a row? Madden, they come out of turn four, down the front straightaway. A Bloomquist and a Rocket battling for the lead here at the Scorcher. In the Lucas Oil 8-Mile Dirt Series, 16 to go down the back straightaway. Ogle Jr. sizing him up. Two drivers with a lot of wins here in the past. Down the front straightaway. 15 to go to settle it here tonight on this Thursday night at Volunteer Speedway. South Carolina's Chris Madden. East Tennessee's Billy Ogle Jr. on a turn four. 14 to go. Bloomquist still trying to get around McDowell. Fifth is Vic Hill. Good run for Eddie Carrier Jr. tonight in sixth. Tell you what, this is not going to be an easy victory here for Madden. He's been unchallenged so far here tonight. Ogle Jr. trying to make it tough on him. One slip up and Ogle Jr. will be right on the quarter panel as they come off of four. with 12 to go at the gap. They dive into one Louisiana J. Brunson almost got in the line of Mandel, the back straightaway. Mandel, Ogle Jr. was going to try the bottom for the lead. Out of turn four, Mandel has the advantage. 11 to go, folks. No, baby. Billy Ogle Jr. on the bottom, out of turn two down the back straightaway. They battle into three. McDowell still third, Bloomquist fourth, fifth is Vic Hill, but all eyes up front for the lead into one. 10 to go. Chris Madden and Billy Ogle Jr., two veteran drivers. As they come out of turn number four, will we pick up the tail end of the field? Trevor Bain, the last car on the lead lap into one. 9 to go. Man running a good line now. As he's picked his momentum back up, Ogle's not going to give up. Billy Ogle Jr., multi-time track champion at the now closed Atomic Speedway as they come down the front straightaway. It's still about 2 to 3 car lengths. Man has got to hold that groove. He slips up out of it. Ogle will be around him. Things happen quickly here at the gap off at turn four. 7 to go to decide it. Meanwhile, Bloomquist all over McDowell. Out at turn four, that's the race for third. Now Trevor Bain, the last car on the lead lap. Down the main straightaway, here they are. Madden, the black 44. The 201 of Billy Ogle Jr., now Bain. And Moyer Jr. down the back straightaway. This could be touchy. Madden goes to the outside. Off at turn four. Down the main straightaway. Madden will clear both Moyer Jr. and Trevor Bain. 5 to go. To go again, we'll interview the top three, and that might be it. Maybe not. Ogle's not going to give up. 4 to go as Ogle clears traffic, but Madden's going to have to slip up now. Eric Jacobson, the last car on the lead lap. Again, your rundown right now, it's Madden, Ogle second, McDowell third, Bloomquist fourth, fifth is Hill, sixth is Carrier, seventh Blankenship, eighth is Owens, ninth Francis, tenth Herb, 11th is Jacobson. 3 to go. Madden now. Ogle Jr. is going to try the middle line. It closed to two car lengths down the front stretch. 2 to go.
Down at turn number two, down the back straightaway. It maintains about a 2-3 car length advantage as Ogle will cut it down slightly into three. Here they come. White flag. 1 to go. This is it. Ogle Jr.'s got to go now. Jacobson in front of Madden down the back straightaway. Here he comes. Ogle Jr. Madden, which way is he going to go? Ogle Jr. out of turn number four, Madden's going to win the Scorcher tonight. Ogle Jr. finishes second. Third is going to be McDowell. Fourth is Bloomquist. And fifth will be Vic Hill.